in over here on my, on my right side to fill in on these seats on my left, if you would. My young ladies and Sister TC, they all go in the back row. But y'all filling on this side, help filling in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Then those that in the back, if you would, don't mind, come up. We have enough room that's up front. Amen.
Woo! Yeah!
Hallelujah. Glory!
Yeah! Yeah!
Hallelujah, Jesus. Let's give the musicians a hand as they, the minstrels. I ain't gonna call them musicians, minstrels. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Ow! Yes!
Hallelujah. Y'all don't know our plans. We're going to do this real quick. We're going to have all of this. Was that not right, Pastor C? That was our plan.
Right.
That's why I told you we're going to say, we're going to do this quick, get them out of here so they can go home. But God.
But God.
Tell somebody, say, but God.
But God.
So don't shortchange God.
Don't shortchange God.
Don't put God in no program.
Don't put God in no program.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. We love you, Father.
Yes, yes.
We thank you for a place that has freedom to worship you, God. God, we got liberty to lift up your name, oh God. God, I thank you for every vessel in this place. I thank you, Lord, for the anointing that rests and resides in this house. We love you, oh God. I thank you for the intercessors. I thank you for the prayer warriors that come out on Friday and label God on their face. We love you today, God. Thank you, Jesus. Can you shout my liberty?
My liberty.
Can you shout out my revival?
My revival.
This is my revival. I'm still stuck on that song from last week, my revival. How many know that God has a revival for you?
Yes.
You could be, guess what? You could be very selfish with it.
Yes.
It's for all, but I want to say it's my revival. I can say it just like the 23rd Psalms. It's, to me, if you want to look at it, it's a selfish song. Because it says, the Lord is
my shepherd.
I shall not want. He maketh
me
to do what?
To lie down and repast.
He leadeth
me
where?
Beside still waters.
He restoreth
my soul.
He leadeth
me
in the path of where?
Righteousness.
For his name's sake. Yea, though
I walk through the valley.
Say, you walk it, I'm walking through the valley. So there's a shadow, but I'm walking through the valley of the shadow of death. And because I can say, I will fear
no evil.
Why?
For thou art with me.
Who? He's with who?
Me.
He may be with y'all, but I know he's with
me.
Your rod. Your staff. Does what? Comforts me. Prepares a table.
Before
where?
In the presence of my
enemy. Then he turned around and does what? Anoint my
head.
Everybody say my head.
My head.
With what?
With oil.
Then it says,
my cup.
She was singing that song, Fill Me Up. She said, my cup does what?
Runs over. Come on.
Surely.
Goodness.
And mercy.
Yeah,
come here, brother. Man, brother, come here. No, come here. You right here, close. Come here. Come on, goodness. Come on, mercy. Get behind me. Surely goodness and mercy does what?
Follow
who?
Me.
Wherever I go. Goodness and mercy.
Yes.
Everywhere I go. Every turn I take. of me. How long does it follow me? I know God is with different ministries, but I thank God his hand is upon Eagles Fire. I thank God his hand is upon Eagles Fire. I give God the praise. And I want you to just give him one more shout of praise before we go right into this word. Real quickly, come on, give him a shout of praise. Come on, give him a shout of praise. That's right, mama. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We're talking today about, we're still talking about relationships and fellowships. And I want to share this morning a talk from the point or from the perspective of how having healthy and right relationships and fellowship gives us the authority of victory in our lives.
Amen.
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 So I want to talk today about authority and how this authority works. Amen. Amen. I first want to give you the definition. I think we learned it. She taught it in spiritual warfare class at one of the studies. But the word authority, there are two words for authority, or the Greek word. One is dunamis. And we get that in Acts 1 and 8. It says, and shall receive power when
after
the Holy Ghost is come upon you. Yes. That's authority there. The word power could be translated authority.
Yes.
Or dunamis. Dunamis is where we get the word dynamite from.
Amen. Yes.
The word dynamite, and I've shared in the past, if you set off a stick of dynamite in a place, it's going to change the whole course of the place.
Yes.
Everything around it is going to blow it up.
Amen. Amen.
Mm-hmm. It has just that much power. So what God says in the book of Acts in 1 and 8, it says, ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. So we receive, we get authority, we get power when after the Holy Spirit has come upon us. It didn't say but not before, but after.
Amen.
That's why you can't resist the enemy without the authority or that dunamis power.
Amen.
How do we know? Peter told, he said, Jesus told him, said, Peter, you're going to deny me three times before the rooster crows twice. Not me, Lord. I won't do it. I'll die for you. Jesus said, you're going to do it. You're going to do it. He didn't get mad. When they came to Jesus, Peter went to get Jesus. Peter said, I don't know the man. I don't know him, they said. You look just like him. He said, no, I don't know him. Then the last time, Peter went to cussing. Not cursing, but cussing. He went to cussing and said, I don't know him. And after he said that, what happened? The rooster crowed, just as Jesus had prophesied.
Amen.
And that tore Peter's heart up. But now, when Jesus rose from the dead, the first thing he did, he told the women, he said, go get my disciples and Peter. He said, go and get my disciples and Peter. And after he came and he saw, and you know, you imagine how his heart felt, but Jesus met with Peter. But then he tells them, go on to Jerusalem and be endowed with power from on high. He's tearing, and on the day of Pentecost, where they were one accord with one place, they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. That same Peter that had denied Jesus on the day of Pentecost preached one message.
Wow.
And 3,000 souls was added to the kingdom. Why did this happen? Because he had gotten that power. Everybody say, receive that power.
Receive that power.
The first church was a mega church.
Amen.
3,000 souls one day. Imagine give an altar call. And the first day you start a church, 3,000 folks come. 3,000 souls. So we don't want to knock mega churches because it happened in the Bible. We like small, but God's will also is for us to be enlarged. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So don't be talking them over. They must not be preaching that. That's why they got a mega church. No. Not everybody.
Amen.
Amen. Not everybody. There's some folk preaching the truth, living the truth, yes, declaring the supernatural and preaching holiness. Yes. And God is adding to the kingdom. Yes. So we don't want that mindset.
Amen.
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 Because we want to talk about growth. Now, the other word for authority is exousia.
Yes.
Exousia, which means jurisdiction. If you're writing a note, it means jurisdiction. Dominion over a certain realm.
Amen.
I want you to hear me. Dominion over a certain realm. It means your right. It also means your privilege or your or our ability. Whenever we say we have a exousia or authority, which is delegated authority.
Yes.
It's what God delegated to us when we got born again. Not only did he give us dunamis, but he also gave us delegation. He gave us a right and a realm. Go to Genesis 1 and then we'll go from there. Everything, I'm sounding like Pastor C.B. teaching, look like everything. We look at it. It starts where? In the book of Genesis. Look at Genesis 1:26. Could you turn this up a little thing?
And God, and he said.
Come on, brother. Let's be, turn this up just a little bit. Turn her up. Okay, got it. Okay.
And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion.
Everybody said, let them have authority.
Let them have authority.
Okay.
Over the fish of the sea,
mm-hmm,
and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth.
Mm-hmm. Read on.
So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them.
Yes.
And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply,
mm-hmm,
and replenish the earth,
mm-hmm,
and subdue it, and have dominion.
Or have what?
Dominion.
Authority. Everybody say authority. Have dominion. Read.
Over the fish of the sea.
The fish of the sea represents the economic system. He says to have dominion over the economic system.
Yes.
We should not allow our situations, our lack of money and lack of not having stuff,
yes,
to have dominion over us. Because,
yes,
in the book of Genesis, from the beginning,
yes,
everybody said, from the beginning,
amen,
it was God's will that we have dominion over everything,
yes,
that God created.
Yes.
We had authority. We had authority. And what happened was Adam lost that authority through disobedience.
Yeah. Amen.
That's why now you see a lot of people with mindsets of poverty and lack and thinking that God don't want us to prosper.
Mm-hmm.
God don't want us to have the best. It's God's will that we barely be making it. That, oh, poor, pitiful me. You know, woe is me. That's our mentality. That's the mindset the enemy wants us to have. But when we look in scripture,
come on,
from the beginning, it was God's will that we have authority in every area of our life.
Amen.
That's even in our relationships.
Amen. Yes.
We should have authority, dominion in our marriage.
Yes.
As singles.
Yes.
Wherever you are in your life, we are supposed to have authority.
Yes.
That's the word of God.
Yes.
Everybody say, that's God's will for me.
That's God's will for me.
Okay, read again verse 28.
And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply.
Be fruitful and add.
Multiply.
Be fruitful and add.
Multiply.
I said to them on Wednesday, I told them they may hear this again. Y'all math students. 4 plus 4 is 8. Y'all smart. 4 times 4, 16. Multiplication is God's will.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Not just add.
Amen.
But God is in the business of
multiplication.
Everybody said multiplication is his will.
Multiplication.
He said, be fruitful and do what?
Multiply.
And what else to do? Replenish. Everybody said replenish.
Replenish.
Replenish the earth. Replenish means where it's lacking, where it's drained. That means you pour back in. Then after we replenish, then he tells us to do what?
Subdue
it. That means you take over it. You take charge of it.
Yes.
You take charge when you have authority.
Yes. Amen.
What did we say the word authority meant? Zook, when one of the words it says is to have dominion over a
certain
realm, to have jurisdiction.
Yes.
Let me say this to you. Your family, your home, this ministry, your life is the jurisdiction that God gave us.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
That's my jurisdiction. If I have jurisdiction, then I understand that I have borders.
Amen.
And within my borders,
yes,
or within my coast,
yes,
everything within it belongs to
me.
If an illegal person comes over into my territory, what has he done?
Trespass.
He's trespassed.
Amen.
And so if he trespassed on my territory, and I have dominion, jurisdiction,
amen,
and authority,
yes,
what right and power do I have?
To take him out.
To throw him out.
Come on. Yes.
I don't have to beg him out.
That's right. Amen.
I don't have to plead with him. I said, listen.
Get out.
Jesus talked about the kingdom of heaven. We know the kingdom of has come when?
When a demon is being cast out.
When a demon is what?
Cast out.
Jesus didn't beg no demons.
No, he didn't.
Plead with him.
He cast them out.
Do you think you want to come out? You feel like coming out today? No, Jesus.
Cast them out.
Everybody said cast them out.
Cast
the reason
out.
He cast them out because he knew who he was.
Yes.
He knew his authority.
Yes.
He knew that he had came from God,
yes,
and he was going back to God.
Yes.
So he
hallelujah
would not tolerate,
yes, hallelujah,
demonic spirits.
Amen.
When demonic spirits of strife come in your home, you have a right to kick it out.
That's
or
right.
You can just say, you can just, come on, have a seat.
That's right.
See, the enemy is not like how we are. He just come in. Sometimes we come in a bad place. We just sit and stay in that spot. But when he comes, he's coming at everything.
Mm-hmm.
He's coming at your peace.
Mm-hmm.
Give it here. He's coming at your joy.
Yeah.
He wants your wife. He wants your children. He wants your money. He wants your health. Because the Bible tells us, the thief cometh but for to
steal, kill, and destroy.
Three things he comes for. He comes to steal your finances, your goods.
Yes.
He comes to kill your body.
Mm-hmm.
And he comes to destroy your relationships.
Come on.
That's his purpose. And when we have God's anointing and his power, his Holy Spirit in us, we will be, it's a disgrace and a dishonor to God if we just let the enemy have it.
Amen.
It's a dishonor to God if I just let the enemy just come in and just destroy, take away my wife and children. And then he gave me the authority to rule and to reign.
Come on.
Amen.
Who'll be a disgrace? God said, how you do that? Why you do? God, he just came in. God says, didn't you know I gave you power?
Come on.
Yes, amen. Yes.
Did you not know I gave you authority?
Yes, Pastor. Amen.
Did you not know that you were equipped with everything that you need to get victory?
Yes, yes. Amen.
I heard a lead open up on prayer this morning talking about everything we need, God already provided for us. Everything. Everybody say everything.
Everything.
Say everything you need.
Everything I need.
You already got it.
I already got it.
God ain't creating no more land. Let me tell you something. Ain't no more land being created. He ain't making no. The trees may grow, but I'm talking about land. All of a sudden, like this land just gonna stretch out there. Now we may buy the property. But the land itself is not stretching out.
Amen.
So we have everything we need. So now, getting into what I really want to talk about. Don't have long. When we understand realms of authority, whenever we understand realms of authority, it will always be a safeguard against getting outside of our spiritual borders. When you understand the realms of authority, it will keep you inside of your borders, your coast. You won't go outside of
amen.
Your coast.
Amen. Yes, amen.
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 Listen, we are limited with certain areas of possessions. Mm-hmm. Give you an example. If I at my house,
yes.
That's my coast, that's my borders.
Amen.
In my house, I can go anywhere in my house I want to, because it's my house.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I go to any room. I don't have to ask Pastor C. Hey, you think I can go in the refrigerator and get some? It's my house.
Amen.
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 But if you come in, mm-hmm. You can't just do what you want to do.
Amen.
You have to come in and ask who?
Me.
You got to ask for it. Now, I'm real nice at the house. But still, there's limitations.
Yes. Amen.
When you realize that your realm, the realms of authority, you recognize that it's so, only so far I can go and have to stop.
Amen.
The reason we only go so far, because if we cross over, we cross over into the enemy's realm.
Yes.
We have left our safety zone. And we have stepped over into the enemy's zone now. Mm-hmm. And then in his realm, his place, he can do whatever you want to do to you.
That's right.
You just better plead the blood till you get back in the safety zone.
Amen.
So we have certain limitations. Amen?
Amen.
Write this point down. When we understand realms of authority, it will enhance and accent our spiritual, our God-given gifts. When we understand the realms of authority, it will enhance and accent our God-given gifts.
Amen.
Whatever gifts you have, it will enhance it and accent it. It'll broaden it and it'll give flavor to it. We understand the realms of authority. Number two, it brings correction to our tendencies to rebel. When you understand the realms of authority, inside of every person that's in this room, we have a tendency to rebel.
Amen.
Because we still have Adamic nature.
Amen.
But when we understand the realms of authority, it brings us a hope. Hold on a minute. I'm not going to rebel against God or his God-given authority. It brings correction. Hold on a minute. That the way you talk to that person, said this to this person, you don't do that.
Amen.
You don't dishonor this person. You don't dishonor leadership like that. Why? Because I understand authority. Everybody has to understand authority.
Understand authority.
Number three. Understanding realms of authority gives us a better foundation in understanding order.
Yes.
Amen.
For we understand the realms of authority. It gives us a better foundation in understanding
order.
Everybody say order.
Order.
I'm going to give you an example. We have, as born again, washed in the blood, men and women of God, we have kingdom authority. Everybody say kingdom authority.
Kingdom authority.
Okay. How do we know? The scripture says, go to Galatians 3 and 28. Kingdom authority. 3 and 8. Start at 3 and 26. Start at 26 through 28.
For ye are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus.
Now, when he said all, did he specify who the all was?
All.
He said all, right? That's it. Nobody is excluded. Read on.
For as many of you as have been baptized into Christ have put on Christ.
Mm-hmm.
There is
this. Verse 28,
neither
this
Jew nor Greek.
There's neither Jew nor Greek. This kingdom authority. Now listen.
There is neither bond nor free.
There's neither bond nor free. Yes.
There is neither male nor female.
Mm-hmm.
For ye are all one in Christ Jesus.
Verse 29.
And if ye be Christ, then are ye Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise.
Now listen, he says, in Christ with kingdom authority, listen to be good, there's neither
Jew nor Greek,
bond nor free,
male,
there's neither Jew nor Greek, bond nor free, neither male nor female. When the anointing comes upon a person, the anointing does not just come on a person because he's a man.
Amen.
Or a woman. He comes upon those who will yield to him. Whether he's male or female. Whether he's a Greek, Jew, black, white, Asian, whatever. Whether he's a child or an adult. In Christ, there's neither male nor female. That's kingdom authority. Everybody say that's kingdom authority.
That's kingdom authority.
Now, but let's look at kingdom order. Read. Go to... I didn't tell you what to read then. 1 Corinthians 11 and 3. Let's look at kingdom order now.
But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And the head of the woman is the man.
Amen.
And the head of Christ is God.
Everybody say amen to that too.
Amen to that too.
Now, he talked about kingdom authority. And with kingdom authority, there's neither male nor female.
Yes.
But when he talks about kingdom order, there is an order.
Yes. Amen. That's good, Pastor.
The reason many times our kingdom authority don't work is because we're not operating in kingdom order.
Amen.
And when you get something that's operating outside of kingdom order, it's called disorder and out of order.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Shout amen in here.
Amen.
If you went to a vending machine and the vending machine wants what you put, you want something out of the vending machine. And if it says it's $1.25.
Mm-hmm.
But when you get to the machine and it says out of order, mm-hmm. You will be kind of crazy to put your money there. And it already, the sign says. You will get no return.
No return.
Amen.
You just have given that company your money.
That's right.
Don't get mad at the machine and go to beating on the machine. Why you didn't give me my chips? It's sad from the beginning. What?
Out of order. Out of order. Yes.
The problem in the relationship is not the authority. It's people are out of order.
Hallelujah.
We out of order. We want it to work. We want God, let your glory come. God said, I will when you get in order.
Yes, amen.
That's why Hezekiah, the prophet came to him and said, Hezekiah, set your house in order.
Yes, he did.
Because if you don't, you're going to die.
Yes, he did.
What did Hezekiah do? He could have been proud. My house in order. I ain't got to set it in order. But Hezekiah said, listen, he turned his face to the wall. And he told God, he said, God, remember, I've been faithful.
Yeah.
I've done what you told me to do. Yeah. When you told me to tear down the idols, I tore them down. Yeah. When you told me to rebuild a wall and the altar,
Hallelujah.
I did it.
Hallelujah.
He said, God, in other words, have mercy on me.
Yeah.
What did God do? By the time the prophet got to the gate, God spoke to go back and tell him, I'm giving him 15 more years.
Hallelujah.
Listen. We want extensions. We want the blessing.
Yes.
But we got to get it on them.
Right. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Church, don't just work like you think it ought to work.
Come on, Apostle.
We just do what we want to do.
Come on, Apostle.
Woo. Glory.
I do it like I want to do it. I come when I want to come. I go when I want to go.
Hallelujah.
Then you placed in a position.
Uh-huh.
And then you won't operate in a position, then you get mad when God starts promoting somebody over you.
Somebody
and then you feel, now you start feeling displaced.
Oh, wow.
Listen, I told y'all a few years ago, didn't it? Y'all might remember, I'm going to remind you today.
Yes.
I told you, if you don't do what you're supposed to do, God's going to send some folks in here. He's going to anoint them and raise them up, and they're going to step over in your place. No sense in getting mad.
Amen.
And God is doing it before our very eyes.
Amen, Apostle.
Amen.
Don't get mad at me. Don't get Pastor C just trying. She just don't like me. No, then we don't like you. Guess what? We got kingdom business to do.
Come on.
And it ain't nothing personal.
Amen.
Tell your neighbors, it ain't nothing personal.
Ain't nothing personal.
Say your neighbors, it ain't nothing personal. If you're supposed to be in a specific place, you're supposed to be there.
Yes. Come on.
We shouldn't have to look for you, call you.
Why you ain't here?
You just don't show up and don't let nobody know.
Come on. Speak.
You just disorderly.
My Lord. Disorderly.
Then got the nerve to want to tell everybody else what to do.
Uh-oh.
Oh, get in your business.
Come on.
Today.
You preaching. You speaking.
You out of order.
Come on. Speak, Apostle.
Uh-oh. It ain't nothing coming in. You won't get no return.
Not a one.
You're spending your time.
Wow.
You're wasting it.
Wasting. My Lord.
God will shift and move you. Listen, let me tell you something about apostolic movement.
Tell us.
Apostolic movement ministry is a moving ministry.
Moving.
Everybody say moving.
Moving.
It's a move.
Moving.
Come here, y'all three. Come here, y'all right here. Come on, minister. Come here. Well, she said she want to be you. Get his line back. Go back. I say there's a moving ministry.
Yeah.
What is it?
Move.
It's a moving ministry. I want y'all just take your time and move. Just walk, move.
Come on, TC, move.
Uh-oh.
Now just stop. Like, come on, they still moving. Guess what? Got to move.
Y'all still moving.
Guess what? And they trying to get you to go, and then she just stopped. This is what they have.
Oh,
yes.
That ass.
Uh-uh. Keep on, y'all come on back around.
Well, I had to be one.
Keep on going, y'all. Come on back through.
Oh, man. They left.
We're going to come back.
Come on back through. Then all of a sudden, he slowed down. Uh-oh. And they back there ready to go. He said,
Come on.
Yes.
Uh-oh. Right now. Right.
Come on back around. Come on back around. He's still going. He's still going, man. Somebody else slow down. Listen, God is like this. Make me see. God forbid that y'all do, but I want to tell you, an apostolic move ministry is a
moving.
Come on, shout it out. Says a moving ministry. Says a moving ministry. When the apostles sometimes have to say, listen, you need to go and sit down right now, because we got some, we got bids, and we on a side bet.
Okay.
Amen.
Amen. Everybody's on assignment.
On assignment.
We get out of order and we want the kingdom of God to flow and move for us.
Yeah.
Come on, gang, too. Get ready to close out.
Amen.
We want the kingdom of God to move and operate and flow in our lives. God says, that's my desire for you, for me to move your life. Listen, God always preparing for the next move.
Yes, Lord.
He's already got somebody prepared to take the next place. If you don't, God already got somebody grooming them. He's already got somebody grooming them and preparing them to take your place. If you don't want to do what you're supposed to do,
yes, he does.
Amen.
Yes, he does. He does.
If I don't want to, if I don't value. If I don't value you, if I don't value you and you, God will call somebody else to value you.
That's right.
Wow.
I may not see your worth. So that's why I encourage you, don't let no enemy make you feel worthless.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
You're worth something. You're somebody in here.
Yes.
God created you with value. He created you with worth. He saw us when we was messed up.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
That's right, thank you, Jesus. He saw us when we had dirt and mud all over us. And sometimes people don't want to put their hands on you. But see, they can't see what's in you.
Come on.
But the apostolic mantle that's upon your life, somebody may discount you and think you'll never be anything. You go through your storm, you cry when others don't want to see it. But in that place, God said, that's why I got you.
Yes,
I want you.
Lord,
yes. I got you on the backside of the mountain.
Yes.
I got you in the desert. I got you over that tender sheep.
Yes.
I got you right now. You smell like sheep. But guess what? I'm grooming.
Come on.
I'm preparing
Hallelujah.
You. Because I want to take you to a place that you've never seen.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And all of a sudden you be in that place and you just burst out.
Glory.
Wow.
Yes.
And then others will see. Oh my God.
Yes.
Look what God has done.
Yes.
Look what God. So that's why it's so important to maintain your relationship with your fellowship with God. If you're out of order, get in order.
That's right.
You have to tell God, God, I've been out of order. I hadn't done what I'm supposed to do. Listen, we don't need complainers killing the ministry. You don't need words. Get them all the clap. I'm glad I can't talk to you. You don't need no crying or just complaining. You see something wrong and all you do is sit up and point fingers and groan about what's wrong, but never stick a hand toward fixing it. Hear me. Sister Kim, Sister Saul, she's Sister Lindsay, said, Sergeant Bishop, we want to help do this. Listen, we ain't trying to stop nobody from doing nothing.
Amen.
Pastor, see, some people, let me say this to you.
Come on, Pastor.
Some of y'all think we like micromanaging. I don't like that.
Come on.
But sometimes we got to micromanage till it get you. You know what? Some of you calls us to micromanage.
Come on.
You know, I like being sitting back resting in the ministry and people handling their business. And it should not be on a handful of people. I don't think we got no visit. He's our brother too. But I'm saying this. You should have your sleeves rolled up.
Yes, Lord.
You don't need to be on the phone and talk like y'all ain't seen this right. Listen, my phone, get my mic go out. That's why I got low. Listen, you should not be on the phone talking about what's not right.
Come on.
Have set it in order.
Yes.
Everybody say, set it in order.
Set it in order.
Say, set it in order.
Set it in order.
Help get in place so that we can fulfill the call God has placed upon our lives.
Yes.
That's all I can have for today, because time, we're racing with time. Amen. I don't want to try to not hold us too long. But I want you to know that God is calling us not to just have kingdom authority.
Yes.
But everybody say, kingdom order.
Kingdom order.
Get in your place.
Get in your place.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you're here, you're not born again, you have not received Jesus as your Savior and Lord, would you come? If you're here and you need healing in your body, you say, I'm sick. We're here to pray for you, because we have kingdom order and we have kingdom authority that the Bible already told us. If we lay hands on the sick, they shall recover. Amen. Come on, sister.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you're here, praise God. Come on, kingdom authority, kingdom order. If you're here, if you want to connect with this fellowship, with this ministry, would you come? Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're praying. We're going to pray. And I want you, everyone in this room, I want you to stretch your faith this way. I want you to lift up your hands and point in this direction. We believe in God for God to bring healing and deliverance and peace, whatever the need is for these souls that at this altar right now. We're going to believe that God is going to bring just what they need. Give them just what they need. Amen. We're a supernatural ministry. We believe in supernatural healing, miracles, signs, wonders, and healing. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Let's begin to just worship Him. Let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. Thank you.
I decree.